All right, hey you guys, welcome back to the channel. I know it's been a while, guys. You do not have to tell me. I have really no excuse other than I kind of did enjoy the time being off camera. I'm kind of boring, y'all. Like, I've been doing a lot, but I've been doing a lot like errand stuff. And to me, I feel like that stuff is just like not really that fun. So I feel like I haven't had the need or want to pull up my camera. But thank you guys for being here. Again, if you guys are new, my name is Leia. And I just bought this new powder. This is the Huda Beauty Cherry Blossom. Look at you guys. I'm going to show you really quick. I'm actually done with my makeup. I'm getting ready because at 6:30 tonight, Andrew and I are going to our nephew's birthday party. So this is supposed to have that really deep pink tint. I don't know if you can tell. Maybe not on camera. I don't think you can tell that it's pink. Not sponsored, by the way. I've never, ever, ever done a sponsored content just because my channel is still rather small. But I just really like it. I've been seeing this like everywhere. Honestly, I think everybody uses this right now and it's supposed to like be brightening. So I got it and I just love a good under eye brightener. So that's what I'm doing right now is getting ready. But again, I'm ready. I gotta do my hair, guys. I kind of like, why the heck did I start my intro with like nasty ass hair? But I have to do it right now. I'm gonna curl it. I don't know what I'm gonna wear. It's literally like a kid's party. Oh, I gotta put some highlighter on. It's at a kid's like bounce place, which I'm definitely not bouncing. I haven't been to one of those places in a long time, but I'm just there to, maybe I shouldn't do my middle finger. I'm just there for support. I'm there, you know, so he has a good birthday. I actually don't even put highlighter right here. I used to put highlighter on my cheeks a lot, which is like the number one place where people put highlighter. Like they'll dip their thing in and they'll put highlighter right here. I don't even do that anymore. All I do is right here. I actually already put highlighter on my brows. So I just do like tip of the nose, like the bridge of the nose, and then the brow and also inner corner, which, oh, I got a hair on me. I could put some of this in the inner corner. I put another highlighter earlier and I think it's very dull. So I'm going to go ahead and just like smack that on there. So yeah, my makeup is done. I've actually gotten a lot faster with doing my makeup recently. It's normally like at least an hour process, or it used to be an hour and a half. I've gotten it down now to like 30 to 45 minutes, which still seems like a lot, but think about it. When you do like a liner, eyeshadow, lashes, it could take some time. So anyway, I'm going to make my way to the restroom so we can do our hair to finish getting ready and we will chit chat some more. So let's go. All right. So I'm in my restroom. I went ahead and put a t-shirt on because I was actually in like my bralette earlier. So y'all don't really have to see that, but I'm going to start doing my hair. But yeah, I wanted to just say hi to you guys. Wanted to see what was going on with you. I have missed you too. And just to kind of like recap what has been going on. Actually, Andrew and I have something like kind of exciting that we want to share with you guys soon. Maybe next month we'll share. If you guys can guess in the comments what it is. It's something like, it's not huge, but it's huge for us. So if you guys can guess, I'm not going to say who's right, who's wrong, because when we like actually say it, I want you guys to like, then you guys will know. But I'm just curious to see what you guys have in mind. But there's like a mini little announcement coming next month. We're excited about. So that's something we're excited about that you guys will find out next month. Other than that, like today right now, Andrew went to go pick up a rental car. We have a brand new truck. Our truck is only like, you guys saw when we were buying our truck. I think I filmed it here on YouTube. We have like a truck that's like a year old. Guys, when I tell you that this truck has had so many problems and we bought it brand new off the lot, it is back in the shop for the third time. Something about the cylinders, like, you know, I have a four cylinder, I have a four cylinder, but mine's a turbo. Andrew has a V8, so eight cylinders. There's always something wrong with one of the cylinders. That's all I know. I'm not really a car person, but that's what the guy keeps telling us. So yesterday his check engine light came on and obviously we're under warranty. So we get everything like checked. especially his car is only like a year to a year and a half. There is no way that it should be having problems. So today he had an appointment at 9 a.m., took it into the shop because his car was, not only was the check engine light on, but it was also like acting funny or driving funny. So he took it in today. Pretty much it's been our whole day. And then right now they originally told him he was going to get his truck back, but now it's going to be staying in the shop for a couple of days. So he's getting a rental car. The place where we bought the car, the Chevrolet place, because we have a Chevy, it is like at least a 20-minute drive from where we're at. And they just called and he has to go pick up a rental car over there. And I was like, are you kidding me? Like, we just got back and it was like it's a 20-minute drive. And I'm like, oh my God. And then I have to get ready for this birthday party. So luckily, one of Andrew's really good friends, like childhood friends, lives next door to us. So he asked him for a ride and I'm like, oh my God, thank you so much, because I did not want to drive all the way back over there. I mean, of course I would have, but I would have been late for this birthday party. And I'm kind of like that person, like I need a little bit of like time, not just to get ready, but like I need like peace and just my own time. And I've been going all day. So I'm like, no, I need some time to just like chill. I need like peace. The fact that he's helping us out, take him to go get his rental, I'm like, thank you so much, because I wouldn't have even had time to just chill out for a bit. I'm like, no, I need a little chill session, because if I'm going to go to this birthday party tonight, like I don't want to be like moody. I need to like, you know, be in a good headspace. So now I can just kind of like get ready comfortably and then go to the birthday party, which I don't plan on being there for a very long time. I think it's like really only like an hour and a half. And then I'm sure a lot of you guys have questions about like flying. Am I still flying? Yes, guys, I am still a flight attendant. I've stated multiple times that I will be a flight attendant for as long as I can be. And I always joke that the company is going to have to fire me for me to leave, because I love the job so much. I love the lifestyle. I love our flexibility. It's just sometimes it's okay to take a break from flying. I know a lot of flight attendants who do that, and I'm kind of one of them where I'm like, okay, I have to step back. I haven't actually flown since September of last year. I definitely need to get back to flying. No, I haven't gone back yet, but I have been a little under the weather lately with different things, which I'm not going to really get into because that's my own medical. But I've been a little under the weather lately, which has caused me not able to fly. So I am sorry. I know you guys expect flying videos, and I do love filming them. But I will say this going forward, I'm not sure how much more I'm going to be showing myself flying. Like, I will show you guys, like, behind, kind of like hotel room stuff, but in terms of on the plane, I don't know, very, very briefly, I heard just many stories of like flight attendants getting in trouble and stuff like that, and I would never want to like jeopardize my job, so I'm even evaluating like what I show now on my channel, which I know before I never really did show much. But now I'm going to be way more cautious of what I do show, and I do apologize, but I definitely will like still have flying videos. I just will show like maybe a different perspective. But yeah, I just have to reevaluate. Like, there are some things in my previous videos that, not that I'm like scared because that I would get like, you know, in trouble for social media, but like there's just some things that I don't want to still be showing. Like, I want to make sure that I'm fully protected and I'm not violating any policies, which I know I haven't. I'm very careful, but I want to become a little bit more careful, because at the end of the day, this is my job and I would never want to jeopardize my job in any way. So maybe my flight videos will look a little bit different. Maybe they won't. I don't know. I won't know that till I go back to flying. I'm being honest. It actually does feel a little bit weird actually picking up the camera right now, because I haven't picked up the camera in a while, and I've done a couple of like fun things. It's just, I don't know. Again, I'm sorry. I kind of forget at times to pick up the camera. So that's on me. I do need to become better. There's many times where I'm just doing like get readies, like sitting down. Honestly, I stated before, like, my favorite thing to do is, like, sit on my vanity and do makeup. But I know a lot of you guys probably don't really want to see that. Maybe I might try to do some more of that on my TikTok. I think I will try to go live on TikTok, do me doing my makeup. So if you guys want to see that eventually ever, follow my TikTok. It's layyahdoll. And my layyahdoll is like all my handles on all social medias that I have. So maybe I might go live on TikTok and just do makeup there. I don't really want to bombard that with here. I want to keep my YouTube as like, you know, something fun, like little updates, travel, you know, things I do when I'm with people. So yeah, that's what I want to keep on my YouTube channel. Just maybe an occasional like get ready with me, but not a lot. And I love get ready with me's, but I'm trying to think, what else do I have to say? Other than I've just been living a very chill life. I've kind of liked it. We had a really good New Year's. I don't know what it is. I just washed my hair yesterday and it already feels like oily. I don't know. And then going forward, what do I have coming up? Other than our small announcement next month for February, I don't really know what I have coming up. I'm so ready for spring and summer. Are you guys ready for spring and summer? I mean, I live in California, so we already don't get the worst weather, but I'm just ready for like spring and summer festivities. I know definitely if you live like places where it snows, you're probably like super ready. But for me, even here, and today was a beautiful day. We had like a 65 degree weather day. The sun's already going down now, but the sun was out all day. The wind was blowing. It was so beautiful, so awesome. So I really enjoyed the day. And I can't wait to have more of those because it's actually been pretty cold here in California, or at least where I live. Like at nights, it's been like in the 40s, which again, you guys are probably laughing if you live like somewhere where it's snowing, but like for here, that's really cold. And then I take my dog out, Sin, to go use the restroom, and I have to put her big jacket on because it's cold. California cold just hits different. You guys probably won't understand. Like, you know, obviously I've been in the cold with my flying job, but California cold hits a little bit differently. So especially like we're not prepared. We don't have big, I mean, I do have a parka jacket. I don't want to say that, but what I'm saying is like, it's not the norm. So even though I have it, I wear it like when I go to work, like it's definitely not the norm to wear these like big, big coats and stuff. So definitely like California weather hits very, very different. But this spring and summer, I don't know, I want to do so much. Like Andrew and I rescheduled our Hawaii trip, which again, I do plan on vlogging that. I'm so excited to vlog that. I'm so excited to go. We're staying at Aulani, the Disney resort. We're going like April, May. And let's see, what else are we doing? I don't know, just like regular things. My birthday's obviously coming up, which I'm not like happy to get older, but birthdays are like, I mean, they can be exciting. Like you're excited to get out and do something. I don't even know what I want to do for my birthday. Like brunch is always the first thing that comes to mind, but I don't really want to go to brunch. I'm being honest. I'm not really like wanting to drink as much anymore either. I just noticed like with drinking, like you really do feel like shit, honestly. Like I want to drink less. Like I told Andrew, like unless I'm going to a restaurant and having like a cocktail, I don't want to just like, I don't want to get drunk at home. I don't want to drink at house parties. And I hate feeling pressured to drink. Like I recently just went to like a house birthday party. And even though it was so much fun, I really didn't want to drink. Like I don't want to take shots anymore. I did a little bit of champagne, but even the next day I woke up with like a headache. Like I wasn't hungover, but I wake up with a headache because the amount of sugar and alcohol, it doesn't excite me anymore. Like being 34 now versus like when I was in my early 20s and stuff, like my life has evolved. Like again, unless I'm drinking a beautiful cocktail, like a martini, I love martinis. Unless I'm drinking something from a restaurant, I don't want to drink it anymore. And even when I go to restaurants, the most drinks that I have are like 2 drinks. So let me know if you feel the same way. I just feel like life changes, life evolves, and I'm okay with that. I'm okay with not being in my early 20s. I love being almost now mid-30s because I'm about to be 35 in May. And yeah, times are just changing. Times are different. I remember if you would have asked me this when I was in my 20s, I would have been like, no, I can't give up alcohol. I love having a good time. I love going out. You know, I love having a good, like, buzz, the way it feels. But now, I don't even feel like I need alcohol. Like, I haven't drank now, I think, in, like, 2 weeks, maybe 3 weeks. I think the last time I drank actually was at that party, which was, like, the first week of January. I'm actually not even doing dry January, only because I feel like to do something like dry January is, like, you have to be a drinker. And I'm not even a drinker, so I'm like, why even do dry January when I'm, like, what am I improving or depriving myself on because I'm not even, like, drinking? So I plan on continuing this, like, past January. It's not just a one-month thing. Like, going forward, I just don't really want to drink. Like, if we go to, like, a nice restaurant, then sure, I'll order a cocktail. But other than that, I don't really care. All right, y'all. So my hair has gotten so much longer, by the way, since I last cut it. I actually have another hair appointment soon on February 3rd. I think I'm going to just, like, relayer, get a trim, texture it, and then obviously cover my roots because I'm starting to get grays again. Things are falling. And then, I don't know, yeah, keep a lighter base. I like a little bit of a lighter base. But yeah, lend me suggestions. What should I do at my hair appointment? Guys, if you want volume, this is the best thing I've ever used. The Powder Play from Big Sexy Hair. If you guys can see that, this is literally, like, it's a little bit gritty in texture. Again, not sponsored. I don't get sponsorships. But it is the best thing I've ever used in my hair. Like, you just, like, work it in. Like, get it in there, work it in. And then I'll show you, like, an end result. Like, look how high that gets your hair. Like, I still gotta style it, but it gets my hair really, really high. Before that, I would, like, tease a lot. But teasing is kind of, like, you know, super, like, 10 years ago. And it destroys your hair. So I'm trying not to tease as much. But I try so many texture sprays. And the best thing that I've ever used is that. And it's also, like, kind of the cheapest. You can find it on sale a lot at Ulta Beauty for, like, less than $10. So I highly recommend that. I'm pretty much ready. I'm not ready. I gotta change, but my hair and makeup is done. And then I'm gonna go very casual. So where we're going is like a kid's bounce place. Like, cause I mean, our nephew is gonna be 7. He's young. So that's where we're going. So I'm just gonna go casual cause it's a bounce house place. And then this is just Kenra hairspray. It's a very, very light hold. I don't like crunchy, sticky, like, helmet hair. So I buy, like, light hold type of hairsprays. Okay, hair is done. And then now let's go find an outfit. I love when I curl my hair. It makes me feel really pretty, 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 pretty. Okay, y'all. So this is the outfit I came up with for tonight. These honestly are my favorite. They're very comfortable. They're from Amazon. I'll link them down below, honestly. Like, buy them on a sale. They go on sale. They went on sale for Amazon Prime Days. They were on sale for, like, Christmas time. And they're also on sale. They do, like, those limited steals. But they're just, like, bodysuits. But they're double lined. They're from the brand Pumi. The brand Pumi. Again, not sponsored. But I have, like, these cargo pants. They are very, very baggy. I don't even know, like, how cute they look. They're definitely, like, outside of my comfort zone. I know Andrew doesn't really like these pants. He'll tell me, like, numerous times that they look, like, very, like, goth girl vibes, which I'm definitely not a goth girl. But I'm always into trying, like, new fashion trends. I definitely, like to stay on trend. I'm just gonna put on my Nike Dunk shoes and call it a day. Ooh, these are still, like, I gotta, like, tap them off. It's been raining here in California a lot, so I wore these, I think, out in the rain, and they still have, like, dried up mud. And I know, weird, right? I'm wearing my Dunks in, like, the mud and the rain, which I shouldn't, but oops. What am I gonna do, right? I'm still gonna wear my clothes. So let me go ahead and put these on and then see how they look. But like I was saying earlier, I try to stay on trend, like, on, like, the trends. I know I've mentioned before that, like, I'm trying to buy, like, basics, which, yes, I'm trying to stick towards buying basics, but there are on occasion where I'll buy trendy stuff to see, like, what they look like. Honestly, I kind of like it. It definitely looks weird because it's baggy, but I think I do like the vibe. You know what I'm saying? Let me show you guys in the mirror, but I have some stuff on the floor that I gotta pick up. I took Sin to get her nails clipped, so I have like her rabies papers out. You have to show your rabies papers, so I have those out and I have to put them away. But let me go ahead and flip the camera so I can show you what the whole outfit looks like. All right, so this is the outfit. Let me know what you guys think. See, they're very baggy, and I think when they're baggy, it makes me look like I have like thicker legs, but I'm actually okay with the look. Like, I definitely am very thick right here. I've always been thick right here. But, I mean, my legs are not that thick. That's my leg right there. So if you look at the difference, like, look how baggy that looks. And then this is my actual leg. Like, my leg is not really that thick. It's just that the pants make you look very baggy because obviously they're a baggy cargo. So I know it's definitely, like, not for everybody. Like, I get it. But I think I might wear these tonight because, honestly, I haven't really worn them. I tried wearing them one time, but Andrew and I didn't end up going anywhere the time that I tried wearing them, so it was kind of like a waste. So I think I'm going to try wearing these tonight, but people are probably going to be like, what is this goth girl? Because, yeah, it definitely looks very goth, but that's going to be my outfit for tonight. So it is what it is. You can't even see my shoes, honestly. I have the dunk shoes on, but you can't even see them. I don't want to wear, like, a boot or anything because, again, we're going to, like, a kid's play zone, so I want to be in, like, a tennis shoe. But that's going to be my outfit, and then I'm probably going to put a jacket on. And I'm out of breath because I'm doing stuff. So I'm out of breath right now, but whoo, catch your breath, Leigh. Catch your breath. Okay, I'm going to put on these little baby earrings. Oh, these are different. Which one am I going to put on? I'll put on these. Okay, those match. Do you guys like silver? Or like, not silver, but like white gold? Or do you guys like gold gold? I feel like I look blurry. If I look blurry, I'm very sorry. I'm still trying to work on my camera. I notice when I don't pick up my camera for a while, I forget how to use it sometimes. Like, I have to reteach myself, like, ISO, aperture, like, everything. Because then I'm like, dang, why do I look so, like, I want to make sure I'm in focus for you guys. But, see, I'm just going to put on these little cute little mini, like, little shrimpy earrings. And, oh, see? I don't like that. Why is it not focusing? I feel like I'm not. Oh, there it is. Sorry, guys. If you guys were, like, out of focus the whole time, I am so sorry. Again, I'm just like constantly learning my camera. Again, when I haven't picked it up in a while, I forget. I truly do. I forget how to use it, and that's why I need to pick it up more. I think it's because my mirror was in front of my, what is it, the viewfinder, and when it's in front, it's focusing on my mirror and not actually on my face. So I'm really sorry that was blurred out. But other than that, y'all, I've been working out more. I've actually kind of made it a point to get on my treadmill. So I get on for 45 minutes, and I've been doing like at least, I'm going to say like 3 to 4 times a week, which is definitely like I need to amp it up, and I also need to like incorporate more weights because obviously the treadmill ain't going to do that much. So did I go blurry again? I'm so sorry, guys. I'm all over the place. But yeah, I've been working out more. So that's something I'm really happy about. And I also actually feel like when you work out, you feel a lot better about yourself. I've been feeling like so much better about myself as a person. And I've been liking the way I've been feeling. I've been in a way better, like, positive headspace ever since we lost Jackie. I got into a really, like, not a bad mental headspace, but just like, it was hard. It was a hard recovery. And I still miss him daily. But as everyone says, things do get better with time. It's already been like 3 months, I think, since he passed. So everything does get better with time. Sin is now like the highlight of our world. We absolutely love her. And it definitely made the transition a little bit easy because we had her to hold on to. And we love her just as much as she loves us. We adore her. I'm going to put on a perfume. What am I going to do? I'm going to wear this one. This is the Mouclair. That's how they say it, Mouclair. So I pretty much do like 2 squirts. And then chest, head, private area. But that one's really strong. These two are my favorite, like, winter night scents. This is the Mouclair Alien. Yes, Alien. It's a small one. I love this one. It's definitely, like, a fall, winter night scent. Same with this one. This is a YSL Libre Intense. I love this one so much. I'm going to go get the big bottle on this one. This is, again, the small one because when I first buy a perfume, I only like to get the small one because even if I may love it in store, I come home with it and then, like, on my day to day, my feelings for it change, or like it may be too strong or it may give me a headache and I may stop liking it. And I thought this one would be that. Same with this. This one actually, to me, sometimes feels more stronger than this one. This one is a very smooth scent. But this one is sexy. And again, this is like a nighttime, winter, fall scent. Like, you definitely can't really wear this in the summer, I don't think. Or if you wear it in the summer, I think it's only like nighttime. So those, like, I love these two scents. I've become definitely like a fragrance person. This was my wedding scent that I absolutely love, the Giorgio Armani My Way. Again, it lingers. It's like sweet, but strong sweet. And I guess floral. Yeah, like more of like a strong floral, but it lingers and it lasts a long time. And the bottle is so cute. I'm really glad that I chose this one for my wedding scent because I love that scent. And I try to really only wear it like on special occasions because I don't want that to become like my everyday perfume. Because I wore it for the wedding, I want it to be like a special perfume. This is literally my everyday fragrance. I love the Coach. I think this one's called the Wild Rose. Coach Wild Rose. I love it. It's not that expensive. Again, this is a small bottle, but I would go back and get the big one. It's such a good scent for every day, and it just smells really good, and it lasts. My ride or die from a long time ago was the Chanel Chance, but I probably won't be repurchasing this. Not that I don't like it. I just like other fragrances more. And then I've been using the Burberry Her for another everyday scent, which I probably I like it, don't get me wrong, but I probably won't repurchase it. I don't know why. I like it, but it's like not my favorite. And then the other one I have is this one, which this is the big one. This is the 3.4. It's the YSL Moon Petties. This is a big one again, but I'm being honest, this is like kind of like my least favorite one because it's just really strong, where like this is like give you a headache. So I don't know, but it is pretty and I do like it every now and then, but it's, I thought I was going to like it way more than I actually do, which I do like it, but it's just not like my favorite, if you catch my drift. So I am ready and we're just going to hang out until we go to the birthday party. Okay, so this is the place. It's called Sky Zone. If I was a kid, this would be awesome. I've never been to something like this as a kid. We never had cool stuff like this. Oh, there's like swings over there. Oh my god. Oh my god. Here, let's go to Jonathan, the birthday boy with the orange socks. He's right there. Hi, pretty girl. Hey, birthday boy. You having fun?
Yeah.
Hi, Aria. You having fun?
Yeah. Come here.
You're all sweaty?
Yeah.
Oh my god, you're all sweaty. Aww. Aww. Yeah. Tell Theo to throw you in. Boom! Go, Jazz! Our thing, girl. You can do that.
I can't. I'll break my neck.
Alright, so there goes the birthday boy. To go down this slide and then it like shoots them up. I'm gonna zoom out. Oh! He's crazy, he's all sweaty. All right, there goes the other pretty girl, Aria, or the only one. The other one, Jonathan's a boy. Andrew's recording, but he's recording slow-mo, which are funny. How was that?
What is that?
What did you bring? He knows what it
you're
is.
You're hired.
But he can't believe it.
You're hired at AT&T.
An associate too. Welcome to the team.
We gotta push you to work.
It's just so
long. It's the same one.
Wait, what is it? What is it?
It's a brand new iPad.
Oh,
yay!
Cute.
Give me my iPad now. Oh.
Wow.
Is
Apple.
He said,
oh, like Apple
product.
Was it brown?
Me.
I see something!
Oh my God, what are you seeing there?
I'm just taking all the credit.
Fans!
Me and Thea.
And I got all the fans! And there's something right there!
And some chonies. Connected to the TV, bro.
Right
here.
Play it
right now.
Oh, you got an Xbox?
Xbox.
Aww.
Hey.
Hold it. I got an Xbox.
I dream come
true. His dreams came true.
I'll take that. I'm one of my
happy. Are you happy? So we are back home. It's the end of the night. It's actually still rather early. It's like 9:11. I am really tired. Like, there was a lot of kids there, and kids are so high energy, and so I'm like, time to come home and be in my peaceful environment. Obviously, you guys know Andrew and I don't have kids yet, so being around that high intense energy, it's like, it's so nice to come home and just have like peace. I will end the vlog here. I have to show you guys something really quick. I have two separate earrings on. Look at this earring. I literally thought when I was putting them on that they're the same thing, and they're not. This earring is way more like smaller and oval, and this one is more round. So no one would ever notice, but I noticed, and I was like, oh my God, like I'm wearing two different earrings. That's so funny, huh? Anyways, y'all, well, thank you guys for watching. I'm gonna actually start taking this off. Like, maybe you can see a difference having them side by side. But for some reason, at first glance, they look like the same earring, but they're not. Can you guys, like, tell? Yeah, they're different. This one's more round. The other one is more like a shrimpy type earring. Yeah, probably right there you can tell. Anyways, guys, thanks for watching this cute little update. And I don't think I have anything else to tell you guys other than I hope you're having a good new year. Follow me on my social media platforms. Instagram is pretty much what I use more. I do want to start using TikTok more. I don't use Snapchat. I have one, but I actually think it's deactivated. I don't use it. I never really liked Snapchat. Snapchat to me was like the cheaters app because you can like send like messages like that. So I never used it. But yeah, that's it. Follow me on social medias. I'll see you guys soon. I'm very tired. My eyes are starting to get like droopier, I can tell. And I'm gonna have to start taking off my makeup. And that's it. I'm going to have a peaceful night with Andrew because he goes back to work tomorrow, unfortunately. So I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye, guys.